God bless you and thank you for joining the broadcast today. We are going deeper in our study of the Proverbs 31 Total Woman. Today we want to start off in verses 16 through 17. And the Bible says this: she considers a field and buys it. From her profits she plants a vineyard. She girds herself with strength and strengthens her arms. If you look at this particular passage of scripture, you'll realize that the Proverbs 31 Total Woman is a planner and a provider of strength for her family. And many of you may look at life and feel like that you don't have strength, that you feel weak. But we already defined, dealing with chapter 1 of the book, that you're not weak, you're not sorry, but you're sure of yourself. And when you have the self-confidence and you have that surety about yourself, then you're able to be a planner and provider for your family. You're able to be a source of strength. And many a times when a woman is defined, a lot of times they don't define a woman by strength, because we normally look at strength as something as a physical ability. But the strength of the woman is the heart of who she is. You are the heart of that household. You are the very trust and faith that your family is depending upon because of your hard working and because of the strength that you have to see your family stay together, to see your family submitted to God, and to see your family develop and prosper in the destiny that you know God has for your household. Right now, your husband and Christ are the head of your household, but you are the very heart, the source of strength, support, and encouragement for that household. And just like in the body, the heart is the very vital center. It's the core, and it is the strength for our bodies. It's where the source of blood pumps through the entire body. You are the living source for your household today. You're the living source that everybody stays in line and stays in order, because they know that when you speak, you're speaking on behalf of the Father. You keep everything alive in your household through the power of God. You are the blood-pumping source of the entire body of your household. You are the survival source. So you have to make it, my sister. You can't quit. You can't give up, because you are the planner and provider from a spiritual standpoint, from a strength standpoint, and from the source, the very core of what's keeping the family together. You are the glue. Many of you might not have felt like you were important. You might have felt less than in your own household, but I'm telling you, as a Proverbs 31 woman, a woman of wisdom, you are the very source of strength for your household, and they need you to survive today, because your survival brings about survival for everybody else attached to you. The Bible says this in verse 18: she perceives that her merchandise is good, and her lamp does not go out by night. This type of woman that's being described as the Proverbs 31 Total Woman is a woman who every day tastes and sees that the Lord is good. She is a blessed woman because she trusts in God. And so many times we trust in everything else, but a true woman of God, a true Proverbs 31 woman knows her trust has to be in God, and she has to have radical trust, a trust almost like the Hebrew boys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that no matter the test, the trial, no matter what you have to go through, you'll say, we know that God is able to deliver us. And that's what you have to go through sometimes when you're going through the storms and tests and trials of life. You have to stand on the trust that you have in God, the God that cannot fail you, the God that can turn impossibilities into possibility. You are a woman who knows that you are being continually blessed by God because you're trusting in Him. And you have to understand, even when things don't go your way, and even when you plan things and they don't work out how you expected them to, you still rely and surrender your trust unto God. You know that God is worthy despite every situation, every adversity. This type of woman knows that her lamp, her light cannot go out just because things didn't work out how she planned. A true Proverbs 31 woman always says, God, here is the plan that I have. Here is the things that I believe for. But nevertheless, not my will, thy will be done. You have to be a woman that will bless the Lord at all times. You have to have a continual praise. Come on, even on this faith journey, you got to take you a beforehand praise. While you're walking out this faith journey, you have to have a praise that says it's already prearranged and it's already done. There has to be a joy that is continual in your spirit, because you realize that everything that happens in your life is for the glory of God. The Bible goes on to say this in verse 19 through 20. She stretches out her hands to the distaff, and her hand holds the spindle. She extends her hand to the poor. Yes, she reaches out her hand to the needy. The Proverbs 31 woman is a woman who looks to the needs of others, because she's already taking care of the needs of her own family and household. Many times I see so many women that neglect their own household in order to have this view in society of being this great, amazing woman. I would never want society to think I'm great and amazing, and the people that I share my home with don't even realize it or don't even view me in that way. Your greatest definition of being a Proverbs 31 total woman will come from inside your household and how you run your household from the inside. Then the outside world will be able to appreciate you. Never seek public praise when you don't have private accountability, even in your own household, for knowing that you're doing what you should do for your own family. Never be out serving the community and doing things even in church or on your job that you're not doing at home. Always know that charity starts at home, then it goes abroad. You have to have an understanding that everything is not about the materialistic. You have to be one that gives yourself, give of yourself emotionally, spiritually, physically. Your time is more valuable than money. And what you do in your household as far as providing that time of emotional stability, spiritual stability, and even physical stability to your house is so important. So many times we as women, we seek again to have the world's approval. We seek again to be viewed in a certain way by the world. But my thing is, your first world, your first obligation, your first ministry is to your household. And I love how it says that she gives up herself to the needy. I want to ask you, what have you been giving away lately? Because many a time, women, we can give bad attitudes, we can give mean words, and we can give ugly looks inside the house and outside the house. Today, be that gift of salvation to somebody. Be that witness for Christ. Be the living epistle, not written on stone, but written on the tablets of your heart today. Show somebody the amazing grace and mercy of God. You have been set apart for a reason, and God wants to see his image, his beauty, his incorruptible beauty, his power and his strength being illustrated in the earth through your life. The Bible goes on to say this in verse 21 of Proverbs 31. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all of her household are clothed with scarlet. This is a woman who does not fear the snow. Understand, snow is a natural cause or a weather event that no one can prevent. A Proverbs 31 total woman knows that there are going to be things that happen that are beyond her control, things that she cannot prevent. No matter what she tries to do, she understands that sometimes it's just a season of life. But the thing about it is, she's prepared for the season. And she knows there's a difference between a season and a cycle. Seasons happen naturally. You know, seasons are things we'll all go through. But a cycle is something that we're continually not learning the lesson of something, and we're constantly repeating. She's not a woman in a cycle, and she's repeating bad decisions or choices and not learning lessons of life. She's a woman that understands her season, and she's prepared in advance for her season. Understand this, that snow is something that falls on the ground in order to cover it up. When the enemy tries to cover up a Proverbs 31 total woman, she is prepared to handle it, because her hope is built on nothing less than Jesus Christ and his righteousness. She puts her full trust in God. What is your hope built upon today? If the enemy attacks you right now, is your hope in your money? Is your hope in your husband, in your job? Where is your hope today? Because I'm telling you, those things will cause you to be silent through a storm, because those things that you're putting your hope in that's materialistic or through another human being are not strong enough to carry you through the trials and the tribulations that can come in the seasons of life. Snow is so cold that it literally kills the vegetation that it lands upon if it stays there long enough. If you allow the enemy to stay on you and cover you up with his mess, his lies, his doubts, then you will die and not produce what God has called for you to bring forth. Just as snow is pretty, the enemy will try to present a pretty picture of temptation to you. When you are trying to pursue the heart of God in order to become a Proverbs 31 woman, the enemy always has distractions to take you out of the will of God. And for many of us, that distraction could be busyness, thinking that we're doing good things, but just because a thing is good doesn't make it God. You have to submit everything that you do before the Father, before you say yes, because your yes could be causing a no, you know, to something greater that he has for you. So always submit everything that you do before the Lord. Ask for his permission when you're pursuing various things in life. But God is so faithful, he always makes a way of escape, even when we do mess up, even when we do stumble, even when we make mistakes. Just like there's a season to everything and there are cycles in our lives, God is calling for us to break those bad cycles. And you can only do this through his strength and his power working within you. Again, when we submit ourselves to the Lord, he will make sure that mess and distractions will not be able to come against us. Just like you expect snow to come in the months of November through February, you should have your calendars marked as to when you know the devil tries to come in, invade your household with confusion and chaos. We all know the various times and seasons that the enemy tries to come and bring cycles in our lives. And you have to be prepared, prepare for those seasons when you know you have to go into a greater level of fasting and prayer to cover your household. Again, you're the heart source. You are the very survival source, the core for your household. The latter part of verse 21 talks about how she clothes her family with double. She does more than enough. You know, she does not allow her family to go without. She's a woman that will even put their needs before her own needs. I believe this means that she dresses them with the whole armor of God. I believe that she prays even more during these snow seasons, if you will. I believe this is a time when she clothes her family in scarlet, which is the color of the blood of Jesus. She begins to speak scripture over her household. She lays hands on her children and she prays for them. She lays hands on her husband and prays for him. This is a time and a season where your prayer life should go to the next level. And don't forget to put yourself on your own prayer list. So many times women allow snow to be on them when their family are thriving and they're suffering under the pressure of feeling like they have to carry it all. But when you pray, you transfer the burden. When you pray, you transfer the responsibility off of you and you put it at the altar in the feet of the Lord and allow him to carry it. And that's the thing the Lord is saying today. Release it from your hands and let it go and allow God to carry it. He knows that you're weary. He knows that the burden has been heavy because you've been trying to do it all yourself. That's why your prayer life has to go to the next level so that you can understand you don't have to carry it by yourself. The Lord already has a plan. It's already been prearranged. And so many times we try to get into the flow of trying to be God for our family, God for ourselves, the Holy Spirit for everybody else. No, no, no. All he's requiring is that you surrender all to him. And today is your day of surrendering burdens because it's too much for you to carry. The Bible says this in verse 22 through 24. She makes tapestry for herself. Her family is clothed in fine linen and purple. Her husband is known in the gates. When he sits among the elders of the land, she makes fine linen garments and sells them and supplies sashes to the merchants. The Proverbs 31 woman is one who's dressed from the inside out. She is one who adorns herself with fine linens like those of royalty. That color purple symbolizes royalty. To me, that means she is a person who dresses holy and modest. She looks classy and she looks like a lady. You know, so many times through music videos and the songs that are out today, it's all about less, not covering yourself up. Everybody wants to show they hips, they breasts, and everything. But I believe that we're supposed to bind ourselves to Romans 12:1 when the Bible says, I beseech you, therefore, sisters, by the mercy of God, that you present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. A Proverbs 31 total woman is a woman of holiness. She's a woman who honors her body before the Lord. She's a woman who knows that it is not about her outward beauty, but it's about the inward working of the Holy Spirit on her gentle, meek, and humble spirit that's most important. She's not a woman who's trying to attract the wrong attention. She's not a woman who's trying to be lustful and lead men astray. She's not a woman who's putting her value and her worth in her looks. She's not a hoochie. Come on. She's not some woman that's trying to be something, you know, because of what the magazine cover says she has to be or what the media and society says she has to be. But she's a woman who knows that the true beauty of who she is the essence of her spirit. She's a woman of integrity, so much so that her husband is recognized as a noble man, as a city gate. As a total woman, you should bring honor and glory to your household. People should take notice of who you are by your inward strength, not just your outward beauty, and definitely not if you're trying to be a seductive woman. A seductive woman does not go in the definition of a Proverbs 31 total woman. She's not a woman that seduces people. Come on, she's a leader. She's a life giver. She's a source of strength. And those things are not seductive. Those things are not trying to be sensual and sexual for everybody. She needs those things for her household, for her husband to see, for his eyes only. Sometimes you got to realize you've been marked for his eyes only for your husband. And if you're single, you've been marked for his eyes only, meaning only for God, until your husband finds you. Too many women are putting too much merit into outward beauty when they're bankrupt morally, when they're bankrupt even in their spirit, when they're so broken on the inside. I would rather be whole on the inside and may not be viewed to be very beautiful on the outside than to be beautiful on my outside and be broken on my inside. I'm telling you, brokenness can cause pain, and many people have chosen their pain over their purpose. And today is your day to say no more, that you are building the character, integrity, and the divine beauty of who you are as a total woman from the inside out, and that you're not going to allow labels and clothing and various things that we, cosmetics and all these things that we're trying to just cover up. What's beyond the makeup? What's behind your lipstick? Because I'm telling you, it's one thing when you add those things as an accessory to someone that's already beautiful and confident. It's another thing when you just put makeup on shattered pieces. You got to understand, in order to see something different happen in your household, you must first do something that you've never done before. Get out of the box of complacency and live life to the fullest. First for God, then for yourself, and then for your family and ministry. A Proverbs 31 woman has great expectation of how the end is going to be. You have to change your perception and your viewpoint right now. If you constantly think negativity, that's all you're going to have. You have to shift your viewpoint. You have to know that you have to have faith right now and believe, God, that the best is still yet to come. Your best days are ahead of you and not behind you. Verse 25 is one of my favorites because it says, strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in the time to come. I know that the times that have been hard, but there is a time to come in your life. Are you ready for the future? Maybe you're not ready for your future because you've not resolved your past. Today, loose yourself. Let yourself go from every soul tied to your past. You can't even be honest with yourself right now because you're so caught up in your past and you're so broken by your past that you can't see what's right in front of you. But today is your day to shift your viewpoint. I want you to know that even if you're not ready, your future is ready for you. And God is looking for you to say yes. He is looking for you to say, I am ready to go ahead. I am ready to forge forward into all that God has for me. God has already forgiven you, and you need to forgive yourself. It's already happened. It's already been done. Now move forward. Don't allow people, places, or things to hold you back in this season, because this is your season for the time that is yet to come. The Bible says this in Philippians 1:6, and I am convinced and sure of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will continue until the day of Jesus Christ, right up until the time of his return, developing that good work and perfecting and bringing it to full completion in your life. God is bringing some things to a completion that he's already started. And if God has started, I'm telling you, it's going to be a good work. So release yourself from the past so that God can bring you into your present and launch you into your future. The Bible says this in verse 26. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and on her tongue is the law of kindness. The conversations that a Proverbs 31 woman has are positive, they're spiritual, they're encouraging, they're godly, they're life-changing. If you know your daily encounter with people is gossip, backbiting, ill-gotten words, you need to shift your mindset in what you say. Don't allow bitterness to come out of your mouth. The Bible proclaims that wisdom and kindness should be upon your tongue, and you have to check your heart. It's time for a heart check right now. Why is it that you find yourself only speaking negativity, speaking about the past, gossiping, ill-gotten words? What is it about you and your heart that causes you to speak such bitterness out of your mouth? In your heart check, begin to search deep, even through the hurt, the pain, the unresolved issues, or what causes you to be so negative. Because today the Lord has said he wants wisdom, he wants spirituality, encouraging words, godliness, and positivity to come out of your mouth. And those things are the law of kindness. Let me tell you, one kind word can shift the outlook of anybody's life. And I want you to test that out today. Start speaking kind about yourself, kindness to your husband and your household, kindness to people that you encounter every day. You need to have self-affirmations. Maybe you need to get sticky notes out and put them on your mirror, and every day you wake up and you speak self-affirmations of, I am a beautiful woman. I am a kind woman. I am a loving woman. I deserve love. Life is good. God is able. That's what I'm telling you to get in the practice of. If you begin in the practice of speaking wisdom and kindness, the outlook of your life will be very great. Verse 27 says this, she watches over the ways of her household and does not eat bread of idleness. Watch what you say. Verse 27 talks about how you should not, again, he's speaking about gossip and mess and being idle. A true Proverbs 31 woman does not degrade people, and she doesn't allow other people to degrade people in front of her. She is careful about what she listens to and what she says. You need to do a music check, a TV check, movie check. I mean, some of you need to check your Facebook and your Twitter, people that are following you and people that say they're your friends, and watch your surroundings and the community of people that are around you and really take a true listen to what's being said. Is there truth and honesty around you, or is it just negativity and lies? Because what you constantly ingest through your ear gate, well, the junk that's coming through those various conversations will begin to corrupt the goodness within you. You know, bad fruit, bad company corrupts good fruit and good company. It can corrupt you. It may not seem like it now, but every seed is a seed being sown in your life, and those seeds of negativity will only bring a harvest of negativity. She's a woman who wants to be healthy for her family. She's a woman who does not let herself go. She cares about her looks. Now, she's not obsessed with her looks. She's not trying to define herself by something the Lord has not told her, but she is a woman who constantly wants to make sure that she's first of all looking good for herself, then for her husband, and then, you know, being healthy for her household. She's a woman that, yes, we all will, you know, indulge in our favorite thing, but she's not letting those things become an idol in her life where she says, I have to have this or I can't survive. She knows that that is only God. She knows that her health is attached to the wealth of her life, and she knows that God cared enough to construct her beautiful body that she does not want to go against it by ingesting junk, both naturally, spiritually, and even through food and bad television and corrupt movies and awful music. She's the one who guards her health in every area. You know, God didn't intend for us to be greedy or gluttonous women, consuming all types of food and mess and destroying our bodies and our health. Today we need to get in shape, both spiritually and naturally. We need to do a workout in our spirit as well as work out in the natural. We have to take care of ourselves. We owe it to God, ourselves, our family, and it helps your self-esteem. So today, do something different that you've never done before. You know, get your hair, your nails, or your toes done, you know, buy new clothes, exercise, eat right, whatever it takes for you to feel better about yourself, because until you love and can feel good about you, you won't be able to go to that next level in your relationship. You have to invest in you so that you can invest in others. And this is not about being selfish. This is about taking care of yourself. And many women right now do not take care of themselves. Because when you're in love with yourself, it makes it easy to show love to everybody else. And my question is this, do you honestly love yourself? Do you love your family, and are you happy with them? Do you know that you are special to God and your family? And if you answer no to any of these questions, then seek God and search your heart as to why you cannot unequivocally answer yes to them. When God made you, he didn't make any mistakes. He didn't make any copies. You are an original. You are authentic. You are beautiful. You know, you no longer have to be a stereotype or a statistic. You can break the mold. I don't care if every woman in your family has been and you fill in the blank. You can break the cycle today. I want you to know that you were a salt in God's mind. And that word salt means to have belief, hope, expectation, and creativity. When God thought about you, there was a belief, a hope, an expectation, a creativity all over your life. And even before he formed you in your mother's womb, God thought about you, how he would create you to be so amazingly beautiful. And when God made woman, he said she's a good thing. And you have to understand this word good means better than average. It means that you are desirable. It means that you are excellent and of high quality. And some sister needs to know today, you are a good thing. Girl, you are desirable. You are excellent and high quality. And when you think about the word create, it means to give rise to produce. It also means to invest in or to appoint to an office. God put you in the earth because you were a good investment. He knew that there was a high and an appointed office for you to hold in the earth. You are a vessel of life. You are source-giving. And that's why a woman is so multifaceted. That's why we have such multiple purpose in the earth. And that word to multiply or multiple means to increase an amount, to have growth, and to have a great degree of something. Right now in your life, getting ready to multiply. There's getting ready to be an increase of amount of peace, joy, prosperity, health, love, grace, and mercy in your life. You're getting ready to grow like you've never grown before, and you're getting ready to go to a new height of degree that you've never gone before. I'm telling you now that the Lord has equipped you with multiple gifts and talents and strength so that you can reach your destiny. Even though you may not even feel like it, it may not even seem like it. Your outlook may make you think you can't even believe in it. I'm telling you from the very thought that God has about you that you would be great in the earth to when he created you and called you good. I'm telling you from this day forward, you will go back to understanding the intended purpose for who you are and not what has caused your life to feel like that you will not make it. The things that you've gone through can't compete from the very thought that God had for you before he even created you. God is taking you back to the very inception, the very thought, the beginning, the source and origin of who you are. And honey, you are a good thing. The Bible says this in our final verses for today, 28-31. Her children rise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many daughters have done well, but you excel them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is passing, but a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her the fruit of her hands and let her own works praise her in the gate. You do not have the worthiness by yourself, but it's because you allow God to shine so beautifully through you that makes you great. When you allow God to shine through you, you gain another level of appreciation for yourself. But those around you will also regard you in a new respect. That's why I said her husband and her children. Come on, not just the one that you love, but even the generation that's coming up behind you will recognize what a beautiful Proverbs 31 woman that you are. Because you were made in God's image, you are very representation of God on the earth. You are his piece of glory that he's left in the earth to be a great blessing. I decree unto you today that you are blessed, you are excellent, you are the apple of God's eye, and today is your day. So So I'm telling you, happy Total Woman's Day. This is a day that you deserve, where your family will rise up and call you blessed, where you will realize that many women are doing well, but to God, you are his daughter that excels them all. You know, when he looks at you, he says, she's my favorite. Yes, you are God's favorite. And I know that's hard to believe for certain women. Some women that are listening to this didn't even grow up with a mother and a father. You grew up maybe as an orphan. You grew up going from foster home to foster home. And you've experienced abuse in your life, and even not just in your past, but in your current situation. But I'm telling you today is the shifting in your mindset, the shifting in your heart, the shifting in your spirit, that you realize that you are blessed. Because the very thought that God had for you, even before he fashioned, molded, shaped you, was that you would be a good thing, that you would be above average, that you would be excellent, that you would be of high quality. And today you have to hold on to the definition that God has defined for you to be. And you have to celebrate that today is your rebirth, and today is your new birthday. Today is your happy Total Woman's Day. Today is a day that you are saying, no more will I live beneath my means. No more will I think of myself as less than. No more will I begin to allow myself to be defined by stereotypes and by society. But I will go back to what the Word of God said that I am, that I am a mighty woman of God, that I am a woman who shall be praised, that I am the daughter of God who excels them all. Today is your day for you to celebrate being a woman, the beautiful woman that you are. And I'm so honored and so grateful to know that I have a sister in the earth as beautiful, as talented, and amazing as you, because we're all standing together as sisterhood so that we can stand fortified, the total women of God, so that we can walk in wisdom and be God's Proverbs 31 total woman in the earth. Well, I pray that today's study has blessed you, and I cannot wait to pray over you. There's a special prayer in the book that the Lord laid on my heart, and so I want to pray over you. I even made a video just for the prayer so that I could be right there, and you could not only just hear me, but you could see me proclaiming the Word of God over your life. So I pray that after you listen to the prayer, that you will get a prayer list out and pray for other women, your sister, your mom, your daughters, your nieces, your cousins, your coworkers, your church members, or just maybe a neighbor, whoever you know, whatever woman you know that's been struggling in her womanhood, that's been struggling, and not she's not been able to live as a Proverbs 31 total woman. I want you today to use that prayer in the book, and I want you to pray that prayer over yourself and over another sister that you know needs prayer today. Because I know for one thing, if we have much prayer, then we can have much power. So I salute you today. Happy Total Woman's Day. This is your day, and I celebrate you, my beautiful sister. God bless you.